Hi everyone, I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch my videos. Don't forget to subscribe and please share my videos. At 1:24 a.m. local time there in New Brunswick, Canada, there was a magnitude 2.9 earthquake. Supposedly no one sent in a report to USGS Did You Feel It website. It was about 4 miles below sea level. Going to Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake close to the large one they had in 1982, a 5.4. And I downloaded two different stations. This one up here, HSNB. And then another one, let me close that, which would be this one down south. That one is BOIN. This earthquake monitor, for some reason, is showing lots of activity. I don't know why. I don't really know exactly where this earthquake monitor is located there. But it is by Boystow. They got a lot of rivers here, and there is one overpass. I really can't see what would be causing all the activity. Let me show you. Yeah, look at it all marked in red. Up here at the top, that is the 2.9. They did not fudge about the earthquake size. There is its spectrogram on HSNB. And we'll go to the seismic signature. Here it is at Boystow. And we'll go to its seismic signature. Back to HSNB. I really don't see anything significant for earth aftershocks. These would be considered, or this one would be considered, interplate earthquakes. And yeah, stress has built up, and it looks like it's basically all tectonic earthquakes that are going on. This here is what the stream view is currently showing. Let me pull it up and over. And we'll go over a little bit farther so you can see the monitor's name. This one here is at Heath Steel Mill, or Steel Mine, excuse me. And then this other one here at, oh, excuse me, I had the wrong name. It's at Boystow. I called it Boystow, but it's Boystow. Extracting this one section right there. Yeah, you can see it's tectonic in nature. Yep, the plates are moving. Look at that. Yep. 40 years ago, January 9th, 1982, it was shook by the largest earthquake it ever had since 1929. I've talked about large earthquakes they've had there in the past. In 1925 and 1929, I believe that one created a tsunami. There was a magnitude 7.0 along the Grand Banks. That's where, let me show you. Down over here, yeah, it was a complete collapse of the Grand Banks in this location. You can see even here how it created an underwater slide. And yeah, it was a huge tsunami, and it caused a lot of damage to towns along the coast and fishing ports and things like that. It was actually a magnitude 7.2. Evidently, the first ever surface rupture caused by an earthquake there in eastern Canada was in 1989. Can you imagine that? The first ever surface rupture? That was actually about 5.2 miles of surface faulting that they found, or 8.5 kilometers. That was a moment, or a magnitude, excuse me, magnitude 6.3. Let's come out with Google Earth. Yeah, first ever surface rupture, which is interesting. You would think they would have had others that were documented. They actually didn't put seismometers in for Canada until the 1960s. Alright, so it's there, and this is the location of today's earthquakes. Okay, we'll bring it back out, and I'll show you again. They didn't find the fault scarp until July 17th, 1990. So the uplift was about 5 feet 11 inches. Yeah, that was right. You might want to go to this webpage and read about it. So this area was mostly bog, and they found that it tore the bog, rose it up 5 feet 11 inches. There was sand and mud volcanoes, freshly cracked boulders, partly drained a lake and created a new lake. It created new springs, or actually both new springs and old springs actually dried up. There was a foreshock 10 hours before the 6.3, which was a magnitude 5.1. As I have stated before, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger. Yep, and stress has built up. It's an indication that stress has built up. Who knows where the next one's going to be, and how small or how large it's going to be. So did you feel this earthquake up there? If so, please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for your support. If you wish to support my work, I'm also on Patreon. You can join for as little as $1 a month. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you.